So, Gaussians are fantastic because what we just did by point-wise multiplying the probability distribution, it turns out that we can also analytically solve that. So what do we have? We want to multiply two Gaussians, G1 and G2. We can fill in the equations for those two Gaussians here. Now, I only care about how wide the results are or what the shape of the results are. I don't care about constants here. So this will be proportional to this here because, see, neither of these preterms depends on x in any way. So therefore, we have the product of these two terms here. Now, e to the a, e to the b is e to the a plus b, which is what we use here. Now look, it's a polynomial of degree 2 here. So that means that we can rewrite this as a new polynomial like that. And it turns out we obtain a new Gaussian. And that new Gaussian has the property that the means of the two Gaussians are weighted inversely according to the relevant variances. This is what we have here. And we have a new standard new variance that is the inverse of the sum of the inverse variances. Now, for some people, that's the best way of obtaining intuition about what is going on in such Q combination cases or in such prior likelihood multiplication cases. So we prepared a little widget, which we want you to explore how the posterior depends on the means and the variances. So please play with the parameters to get an intuition. So much of neuroscience and neurotheory is built on Gaussians that it's really important for you to have an intuition for these things.